In the past few days, we've had further outbreaks of xenophobic violence on the West Rand and here in Cape Town in Philippi, to the point where in one of the townships on the East Rand, someone was actually burnt alive. So the level of barbarism that exists in our society is reflective in that kind of behavior. Now, when political commentators talk about the reasons behind xenophobic violence, they talk about the fact that particularly the black section of our population, that the situation is reflective of deep levels of unemployment, poverty, and inequality. Now, that is true. It would have been true then as well, with the first outbreaks, which was around about 2000, between 2006 and 2008. So obviously the problem hasn't been addressed because it's continuing. So it would mean that important role players like the government, which is supposed to act out against unemployment and poverty and inequality, has certainly done nothing to address that particular issue. And so that brings me to my second point around the past budget speech that just took place this week. I was fortunate enough to attend. I won't go into too much detail about the actual specifics about the budget, except to make a few highlights. For the first time in 20 years, personal income tax has been increased by 1% across the board. In other words, those who are fortunate enough to have a job, there's an extra tax that you will have to pay. Now, in the South African context, because so few people work versus so many people being unemployed, we have the interesting phenomenon that although you might be working and you have a family, you're normally responsible for an extended family as well. So any increase in personal income tax will decrease your ability to take care of your extended family. That's the first outcome of an increase in pay as you earn. The second one is increases particularly in electricity, which is supposed to be a basic right, and an increase in the fuel levy. And the government is arguing that this is critical. Problem with that is that in order for goods and services to move from point A to point B, you need fuel. If the price of fuel is increased, the manufacturers of goods and services basically devolve that cost down to the consumer. In other words, they might say it's a fuel levy increase, but the objective of that would be an increase in inflation. As soon as we have an increase in inflation, the cost of food goes up, which actually mitigates against the fact that they're supposed to alleviate poverty, alleviate unemployment, and alleviate inequality. So in other words, there's a direct link between the kind of violence and barbarism that we see in our society and the way the government makes choices around economic policy. And it's important for us to take note of this because in as much as particularly this kind of violence is directed at Somalis in particular, most of the Somalis, at least 98% of them, are Muslims. So besides the government not really addressing this issue, I think Muslims generally, both at the level of ordinary Muslims and the leadership, should be doing much more to address this issue. Otherwise, it will just continue.